Greetings, this is another video review by the flashlight reviewer known as Selfbuilt. Today I'm going to look at two new lights from JetBeam, the RRT-21 and RRT-15. These are part of a long-standing series of rapid response tactical lights, as they call them, the RRT series. These ones are maybe a little smaller than some of the earlier ones. First, a general comment about the overall build. Although they do look somewhat reminiscent of other JetBeam lights, there are a few differences. As you may know, JetBeam was acquired by SysMax some time ago, as was Nightcore. And I think you can see there's sort of some mixing and matching of the DNA of the two brands in these new lights. I'd also say there's some aspects of Sunwayman light in here. You can see the anodizing is flawless on this sample. It's a beautiful dark gray natural finish. The light has a very smooth, a very high quality presentation, exterior look and feel. One comment about the old JetBeam lights is they were sometimes a bit rough around the edges. There'd be little aspects that made them feel more like custom lights in some ways than a mass-produced light. For good or ill, I find these do have more of that look of a mass-produced light. Still very high quality, though. A few aspects I'm not quite as crazy about, though. You'll see the clip is just a standard clip-on clip, although it's fairly sturdy and holds on fairly well. It's very similar to the more budget line of JetBeam lights, so it's a little disappointing to see it here. Lights have a lot of nice features. There is another feature as well, is that there are no crenellations of the bezel, so it's a flat bezel. Some people prefer a bit more of a raised bezel, some prefer an aggressive one. I actually just like a little bit of a raised crenellation on the bezel, just so you can see if the light is on when you turn it upside down. But other than that, overall feel is very good. Grip is good. It's a little smoother than some lights because of the very smooth anodizing, but there are a few elements that help with grip. I think you can see that a little bit more on the RRT-15, which is a larger light with a larger head. There's a bit of knurling on the body in this case, which there isn't on the RRT-21. You'll also notice there's knurling on the grip ring. Here, this actually is the control ring that controls the output, which is kind of nice. One of my complaints with some of the other rings, some of the other lights that have a ring that you turn, if there's not a lot of grip or differentiation from the rest of the light, it's sometimes hard to find it when you're trying to figure out where the control function is. With a bit of a grip, it makes it easier to find the ring and turn it as you like. Again, a similar build on one sense, no crenellations on the bezel. The lights can both tail stand, although they might be a little wobbly, as you can see. Overall build is fairly strong. I'll show you on this one. There is a good number of screw threads. In fact, more than usual, I would say. You can see how long it takes to get the tail cap off. I don't know how well you can see that. I'll try to focus and let it focus a bit better. They're not square cut, the screw threads, although they do seem to be fairly high quality. They're anodized for tail cap lockout. They're fairly standard looking kind of tail cap clicky with a silver spring. You can see in the tail cap. I've seen similar ones on Nightcore lights. So another example of the overlap between Nightcore and JetBeam, I think. Feel of the threads is good, not gritty or anything, but again, they're not square cut or machined as like you'll find on some of the newer, higher end lights from some of the other builders. Get that on and working. So, forward tail cap clicky, you just turn it on, press for momentary, click for locked on. You control the output by the control ring. So there's off, there's an off position, it's really a standby on the ring. And as you turn it up, light comes up and increases in output. Now, one thing you'll probably notice, let me just sort of scroll down here so you can see as my fingers turn the ring, there's not much of a change in output initially, and then it goes fairly quickly to off. You can see you go through the lower levels very quickly, and then you spend quite a bit of time to get through the high levels. So what this basically means is it's not a linear, or visually linear control ring. The control ring most likely functions in a current linear fashion, which means you spend most of the time in the very near max output levels and very little time in the low output levels. One thing I personally prefer is what people refer to as a visually linear light or a logarithmic ramp in output. The reason for this is you don't actually perceive light in a linear way. Our eyes and brains are adapted to respond to different light levels in a different format, not a non-linear format, if you like. Most people tend to see this as logarithmic, although recent research over the last several decades suggests it's actually more a power relationship with a cube root relationship of output to perceived brightness. And I'll have more to say about that in my actual review of the light, and you can compare it to some other lights. When you get used to it, of course, it's certainly fine. The only real complaint I have with this particular one is that it doesn't go down to as low a level as I would like, and there's very little differentiation on low levels before you get into very bright levels. So that's the one aspect here. It doesn't go quite as low as some other lights with this kind of interface, although it still goes probably to a reasonable low level that most people would need. This particular model, the RRT-15, is set for 3x CR123A camera batteries. You can also run it on 2x18500 lithium ion, which I'm doing right now, which is a convenient size. Most lights that take the 3x camera batteries can also do pretty well on the 2x18500. The RRT-21 is a smaller light designed for, again, easier to carry, pocketability. Takes 2 camera batteries, CR123As, or 2, I think it takes 2 RCRs. Yes, I've tested it with both, and as well as 1x18650, so kind of the standard battery size. Another comment, you can see, I don't know how well you can see that on the camera here, but it's a fairly smooth reflector. And basically to give you a better throw, that can sometimes produce a slightly ringier beam. What I find a little unusual is the RRT-51 has a textured reflector, as you can see there. So despite the bigger head, which would usually be used to give you better throw, they've gone and textured the reflector to smooth out the beam, yet on the smaller head, they've used the smooth reflector to enhance the throw. So not quite sure why they went that particular route. I would have expected more to have a textured reflector on the smaller head and a smooth reflector here to enhance the throw. But you can get detailed numbers on what the throw and output is like on my detailed review. Certainly they're reasonable for the class and the size. No real surprises there. And the actual handling and use of the light I find has been very good. So again, I really like the extra grip that you get on the ring. It's not quite as aggressive as it could be. Some people like it more aggressive, makes it easier to find, but I find it's aggressive enough so you can differentiate it from the rest of the light, which is really what I care about, so that you have a pretty good grip when you go to access it and change the output. I hope more manufacturers actually go to these magnetic control rings. They're very intuitive, very easy to use. The kind of light you could kind of sort of hand to anyone and they'll have a pretty good idea how to use it right away. The one comment I would make though, that it's important on these kind of rings that have an off state, that's really only a standby state. It's always drawing current unless you click the tail cap off. And it's an important point because in this case, as you'll see in my review, the standby current is fairly high and will drain a set of batteries within a couple of days if you leave it like that with the, locking out the tail cap by a quarter turn or by clicking it. So always recommend you make sure you store your light in a state that's permanently locked out so you don't accidentally drain all your batteries. Anyway, that's not specific for this light. That's a standard warning for all lights, although it's probably more important in this case given that the standby drain is higher, I find, than typical for this type of light, although still reasonable if you consider that you can always lock it out at the tail cap. And that's an overview of the two lights. For more information about them, including detailed run times and beam shots, please see my flashlightreviews.ca website, which has links to all my reviews, including these two lights, that have all been posted on Candle Power Forum. So you can alternatively go to Candle Power Forums directly and check out the lights there. You'll find me in the review section under the username selfbuilt. Hope you found that useful. Thanks for your time.